Welcome everyone to chapel. It's so good and great that you could join us today as we hear God's word and sing his praise and learn more about him. To start our worship, we are going to call upon God's name. And as we call upon God's name, what you can do, if you want, is you can do the sign of the cross. And that is just a reminder that God is present with you. Just as we call upon God's name, when we do that, it reminds us that God is present with us because he promises that he will be. So we start in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you have gathered us together as your people, and Lord, you have promised to be in our midst. As we hear your word, as we encounter you, we ask, O Lord, that your Holy Spirit would come upon us, that you would guide us in your ways, and that most of all, we would live in the grace of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died and rose again so that our sins could be forgiven, and so that we could always be called your children, your sons and your daughters. We pray all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's start with our first song.
Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever. Our hope, our strong deliverer. You are the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord.
You do not fade, you Hey everybody, I love Carpool Worship, and you never know who's going to come in the car. Usually it's a Bible character, but today it's somebody that each and every one of you know. That's right, it's our very own Mrs. Coyle.
Hey, Mr. Chef.
Hey, Mrs. Coyle, welcome to Carpool Worship.
Yeah,
what is new with you?
Well, I'm not going to lie, I'm kind of worried.
Worried? Worried about what?
Well, see, I'm so worried I forgot to put my seatbelt on.
Well, you better put your seatbelt on.
I know,
hurry
up. Follow the rules here. Okay, I have so many things going on right now. Work, my extended family, it's the end of the school year. We got dioramas, we got research projects. It's going to be summer soon. I'm planning for a vacation. What do I cook my family for dinner? How do I get Trevor to his baseball game while Grant has lacrosse? And then we got all these other things to do. I can't be in two places at once.
Well, that sounds like there is a lot going on in your life right now.
I mean, it's all fun, but man, you can say that again.
Well, when I'm worried about the things that life throws at me, I have to remind myself of the peace that I get that knowing that God is in control.
But there's so much to do. How am I going to get it all done?
Yep. When we trust that God will take care of us, when we put all our faith, hope, and trust in Him, I'm reminded of the song, The Blessing, the one that we sing in church.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a prayer.
Yeah, that's the song that uses the words that Pastor Bo says at the end of every service. May the Lord bless you and keep you.
That's right. And when Pastor Bo says it at the end of the service, it's technically called the benediction. It reminds us to leave the service and that God will keep us safe and take care of us. With all the worrying that you have to do these days, I think it's a good reminder that God is with you every step of the way. So why don't we sing that song?
I think that's a great idea.
All right. It is a good one. I like this one.
Lord bless you and keep you. Make His face shine upon you. Be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace. Amen. coming, and
You are welcome. And we all need reminding sometimes that God is in control and that he's always going to be with us.
Amen to that.
Amen.
So together right now, let's pray the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. We'll see you next time. Go in peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hey everybody, I love Carpool Worship, and you never know who's going to come in the car. Usually it's a Bible character, but today it's somebody that each and every one of you know. That's right, it's our very own Mrs. Coyle.
Hey, Mr. Jeff.
What's hey, on? Mrs. Coyle, welcome to Carpool Worship.
Yeah,
what is new with
time.
You?
Well, I'm not going to lie, I'm kind of worried.
Worried? Worried about what?
Well, see, I'm so worried I forgot to put my seatbelt on.
Well, you
on.
Better put your seatbelt on.
I know,
hurry
we gotta
up.
Follow the rules here. Okay, I have so many things going on right now. Work, my extended family, it's the end of the school year. We got dioramas, we got research projects. It's gonna be summer soon. I'm planning for a vacation. What do I cook my family for dinner? How do I get Trevor to his baseball game while Grant has lacrosse? And then we got all these other things to do. I can't be in two places at once.
Well, that sounds like there is a lot going on in your life right now.
I mean, it's all fun, but man, you can say that again.
Well, when I'm worried about the things that life throws at me, I have to remind myself of the peace that I get that knowing that God is in control.
But there's so much to do. How am I going to get it all done?
Yep. When we trust that God will take care of us, when we put all our faith, hope, and trust in him, I'm reminded of the song, The Blessing, the one that we sing in church.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a prayer.
Yeah, that's the song that uses the words that Pastor Bo says at the end of every service. May the Lord bless you and keep you.
That's right. And when Pastor Bo says it at the end of the service, it's technically called the benediction. It reminds us to leave the service and that God will keep us safe and take care of us. With all the worrying that you have to do these days, I think it's a good reminder that God is with you every step of the way. So why don't we sing that song?
I think that's a great idea.
All right. It is a good one. I like this one.
Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you. Be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen.
Need reminding sometimes that God is in control and that he's always going to be with us.
Amen to that.
Amen. And we'll stop there.
Hold that track, Carl.